Gary, I'm Sean. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. So we do a lot of gear reviews. Moving more into, it was a lot of backpacking, camping, stuff like that. Mm-hmm. I came on as like an alpinist rider. A lot of climbing and alpinism, so I moved more into that market.
Yeah.
Give solid reviews on that kind of stuff, but also just showcase what people are out there. I'm a huge fan of Western. He's owned 4 of the bags.
Yeah.
Got the booties as well. Those are probably our favorite piece of gear.
Yeah.
But just wanted to, maybe you could run us down the line, show us what you got.
Yeah. I mean, there's one bag that's gone already, the Ultralight. That's our most popular model. We make it in a couple of different widths. The Ultralight is the narrow girth bag, and the Alpenlight is the wider version of it.
Okay.
Our extreme light fabric. This is, you know, all of our fabrics are basically made specifically for us. We buy them with a balanced construction. That's what we think is important. So we're not looking for something with a, you know, fancy, flashy kind of a diamond weave or anything like that. We just want it to be downproof for many, many years.
Okay.
And so on this, the fabrics might look kind of plain, you know, from sanding back, but they're all really made to be downproof for a lot of years. And normally it's cheaper to weave fabric by putting a lot of yarns on the warp loom and then spinning it out really fast because you put very few in the fill direction.
Okay.
You know, it's cheaper to weave that way, so you have to slow the weaving looms down to fill it with just as many threads. So we pay a little more, but it's important to us that, you know, the down inside can last like 60 years, so why put it in your shell until you start leaking down or falling apart after, you know,
2 or 3 years.
10 years, you know, 8 years or whatever. So. Yeah, all the little things that we do with construction details and stuff are just to make sure that the shell will hopefully last as long as the down.
Awesome.
You know. We have, you know, three-dimensional collars, so they're not just sewn on at one point. These are all double-stitched, and then we anchor the port, so you can see right here this slat lacing. This easiest way to anchor a shock port is just to loop it and sew over it. So if you feel alongside of any jacket you have that has a shock port, you'll feel a little loop, and that's where it's anchored. And we take each side of it and we hot cut these flat lacings, we roll it open, and then we put the shock cord in that, and then that gets triple stitched into the seam.
So you're getting more contact here.
Yeah,
well.
the flat lacing is a better better anchor.
Definitely.
Anchor material than the round elastic, because the needle can kind of deflect on either side of the elastic.
So 10 years from now, you're not gonna pull it out.
Yeah, we've had only 2 pull out in the last 20 years, you know, and in those cases, the seamstress just probably sewed it a little too much and it kind of cut the cord.
Yeah.
So every now and then, but that's pretty low return rate. You know what I mean?
Oh, definitely. So, 2 in 20 years is amazing.
Yeah, and that's one of the things that if somebody was to try and take apart our bag and reconstruct it, you know, we could make, you know, they would eliminate those things, would be out the window right away. There's no way a factory would take the time to cut these little things on each end and sew them in their first sew them in. I mean, it just takes a lot more time.
Definitely. Now, what's with the tags here?
That's just to show that there's two seamstresses that have made the bag. And those are their signatures. So
that shows they really take pride in it,
yeah. Most like large-scale factories, it's not like the sewing skills in San Jose are any better than any part of the world, really. But we're only doing this, and there's only 2 people working on the bag. So they each know how each part of what they're sewing affects the rest of the bag. You know, they're not going to take too large of a seam here or not enough of a seam here because, you know, they know it's going to impact either the loft distribution or something, you know, or if they're baffling the bag. So we have one seamstress that will baffle the bag, basically sew all the netting to the outer shells, sew the outer shells together, and then another person that will put all the parts in the zipper on, so the collar parts. And all of these parts, by the way, are hot cut, so they're cut with a hot knife, so the edges will never fray. So I think one of our bags, you know, on average takes around 4 hours to build, maybe 4.5 hours of labor. And the hardest bags, about 8.5 hours. You know, so like something like a Bison, these bags here would be like 8.5 hours long. And those are at least double what it would be at a larger scale factory, probably, you know. They just break it down into a bunch of little micro steps. And one person's only sewing one little thing and they're getting paid piece rate for it, you know. So they might not even know they're sewing little Velcro tabs only all day long, and they're sliding them over, and somebody else is putting all the things together. It's kind of like a disjointed way of manufacturing, you know. It's like
if you were going to have a race car motor built, would you want like 40 Jiffy Lube employees or two master mechanics? You know, that's the way we kind of see it.
Definitely. I love the 3D baffle here. A lot less chance of it moving around.
Yeah, it's stout. It's anchored in two different places. And we started double stitching when we anchor this to the bag, too. We didn't used to do that a long time ago. And so, I mean, there's a lot of things that we do behind the scenes to make the bag last a lot longer, but I think we're one of the only companies that would actually add steps to the manufacturing process like that.
Instead of cutting.
Because we saw that old bags that were coming back were kind of like leaking right here or at the side seams, and it was because they were single stitched when we attached those parts to the bag. So we started double stitching them so that it minimizes the down leakage through the seams.
That's awesome.
Yeah, so we think that the bag should last in the 30 to 40 year range if they're cared for properly.
And this is the Alpenlight?
This is the Alpenlight, yeah.
Alpenlight?
Yeah.
And what do these retail for?
These retail for... The Alpenlight is $585. And the Ultralight, which is a narrower counterpart, is $525.
Yeah. Okay. Cheaper with the Ultralight.
Yeah, it's narrower, there's less down. I mean, the down is a really expensive raw material for us, so that's...
where it comes. Awesome.
But by and large, yeah, they take a long time to construct and they're well constructed. There's no extra zipper pockets for your smokes or anything like that. We eliminate all those things because they add to up to a ball of extra stuff. You know? Mm-hmm. So we want to eliminate all that. So our bags are just clean, they're functional, they're warm, and they last a long time.
Awesome.
Yeah. Lightest jackets that we have are gender specific. This is a quick flash jacket. It's got no cord locks or anything. We want to make it as comfortable and as lightweight as possible. So these weigh, you know, in and around 7 ounces somewhere.
Around
depends
seven
on
ounces.
Which size you get. You know, if you get an extra large, it's a little bit more. If you get an extra small, it's...
And how much downfill is in the 7 ounces?
There's about 2.5 to 2.75 of an ounce of down in the medium, which is a little bit lighter than 7 ounces. Mm-hmm. So large is a little over 7 ounces. Medium's a little bit less than 7 ounces. Mm-hmm. And the fill of a large would be around 3.25.
So it's on like 40% down.
Yeah.
That's impressive.
Yeah. Yeah, and these, there's a lot of quilting time, so there's a fair amount of sewing time. So, you know, the jackets take a little bit longer to sew, but it evens out the down. There's good down control in it. It's not going to shift around a lot.
Having the extra stitching in that a lot of people don't do to keep the down center.
Yeah, I mean, it keeps it in place and it's good for layering. So if you have this jacket under in a shell jacket, you've got a good amount of warmth. But it's a comfortable jacket. It's got insulation on both sides of the pockets, which is, for lighter jackets is not super common. So a lot of times it won't have any down behind the pockets. And then we have some hooded flash jackets. These are made still gender specific, so there's men's and women's sizing. Insulated pockets on both sides. This has a hood, a lightweight hood, and it's made in a breathable but downproof material. It's actually a mini ripstop. Yeah.
Oh, cool.
Looks like taffeta, but if you look up close, you'll see a ripstop pattern.
Yeah.
And the XR is a more weather-resistant version of this jacket. So if you didn't want to wear a shell on the outside, you wanted something with the laminated fabric, that's what you get here. So it's zipper pockets.
And is this water-resistant or?
Yeah, it's a waterproof, breathable fabric. So it's a laminated fabric.
So it is full waterproof.
Yeah, it's not seam taped or anything like that. The fabric is waterproof to around 10 pounds per square inch.
Okay.
Seams would leak technically at about 3 pounds per square inch, so the seams are going to leak first before the fabric.
Gotcha.
It's basically if you lean on a puddle, that's enough to probably push through. So
okay.
Your body weight on that just heavy
light
dew or anything. Yeah.
Especially up in the high peaks where it's nice and dry.
Yeah. And this is a flight jacket. This is a lightweight, down sweater basically. It's got more down in it and fewer quilt lines. This is sewn through. All of these are sewn through. Only when you get to our warmest parka is it baffled.
Okay.
And this is a lightweight, packable jacket. You put this under a shell and you're good to go. This one does have an adjustable waist on it.
unisex. Yeah, it's unisex now because it's got more down. So once we get to a beefier jacket with more down, we don't go gender specific anymore.
It's just more.
This is the best version of it. It's got insulated pockets on both sides, a little thick collar. And this one is weighs about 10-11 ounces, depending. And it's got an even slightly more percentage of down in it than the other. This one has, it's 10 ounces, but it's for a small, but the amount of down in it is four and a half, something like that.
Four and a half, awesome.
Around 4.5, 5, so a little bit.
Feel that one. Yeah, it weighs nothing.
So we have the Vapor jacket, which is similar to this, but it's got a little bit closer together quilt lines.
Okay.
But it's about the same warmth as that. However, this has a more windstopper shell and a different cuff design. This has just got elastic cuffs. This one has a little wrist gasket that kind of seals around your wrist.
Yep.
And then it's got kind of an open, you know, so the idea is your glove might, you know, fit between the two, you know, but it depends on what kind of gloves you have and stuff. Yeah. If you've got big gauntlets, then those might go up and over, but, you know, if you've got regular post-fitting gloves, then it should fit right
between. Definitely.
And the meltdown is kind of, you know, warm blade parka.
That name.
And this one's got the insulated hood that tucks away into the, So it's got a really thick hood collar. And then there's an insulated hood inside that collar, so you can pull it out.
Pull it
out, put it over your head. And it's got an adjustment on it. This one has zippered pockets, more down. Obviously, the quilt lines are farther apart, so it's got more down in it. And this is a microfiber shell. So.
Okay. Nice feel to it. Mm-hmm. Do you know how much down is in this one?
This one has got 5.5 to 6, somewhere around there, okay. Yeah.
Definitely getting to the heavier side.
Yeah, and then the total weight of this is...
dual zippers as well.
Total weight, depends on the medium, I think it's around 16 ounces on this one.
It's got the belay zipper.
So a 1 pound down jacket, it's almost half down. That's awesome.
Yeah. The shell fabric is a little bit heavier on this than some of these other ones. This is
that's robust.
Also a dot rip, so it's hard to tell when it's a rip.
Yeah, you can see the
really tiny rip stuff.
Yep.
But this is a microfiber, and that just means that each yarn has more filaments in it than the denier and thickness of the yarn. And then this jacket here is an Ion Parka, and this is basically, if you take this jacket and make it a little bit longer, and then you cap it with a Gore shell, then that's what this is.
It's
a three-layer jacket. It's a inner jacket like this, and then it's capped with a Gore shell. That's pretty gorgeous.
So that's when stuff gets real nasty.
Yeah, and both of these jackets have two-way zippers, so you could operate a harness and
harness.
Stuff.
Yeah. Shiver, baby.
Yeah. And then the last parka that we have is the Snowjack parka, and that's baffled everywhere except for underneath the arms. So right under here, it's sewn through right under here so that you can have a good arm movement. So if you put it on, it's not, you don't feel like Gumby, you still move around.
Is that this green one over here?
Yeah. It's got three adjustments in the hood and two draft flaps on the zipper. One is, both of them are insulated. One goes to this side, the other one goes to this side. Yeah, so it keeps out the hood.
That's awesome.